We have to visit some of sensitive and very overly protected brands. By me saying this, I might have offended quite some friends from the luxe community. Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. I am so excited to be sharing some of controversial topics with you guys because I have done a research and I have come up with 10 most popular bracelets that everybody loves, but I personally wouldn't get. And I'm going to be walking you through on the reasons why I would not purchase these. You guys know I adore jewelry. All of these pieces are really popular and maybe some of them are on top of your list and perhaps you own it. I respect your decision and I wanted to share my perspective with you guys. After owning some of designer jewelry myself, I do think some pieces are more practically designed than other, even though they all have beautiful aesthetics. I know today's video is going to be a little bit controversial, but I'm here to hopefully assist you in looking at it differently. If you own some of these jewelry pieces, that is wonderful, and I just wanted to say I don't mean to bash you. Just like maybe you won't like some of the pieces that I personally own, just get into the facts and here are the reasons why. There's no particular orders in this video, I just have my list of 10 items. So I'm going to be starting with the very first one, which is a piece from Tiffany's collection. As you guys know, Tiffany has been rebranding, or now they're a part of the LVMH group, and I'm pretty sure there will be more changes coming up. However, when they launched the Tiffany T collection, it is rolled out as one of their signature collections that is added in their fine jewelry line. I do love the design of the T1 collection. However, I'm not the biggest fan of the double T, Tiffany T bracelet, as I do think the hinge design could wear off very easily, and I don't necessarily love the design of a double Tiffany's T initial. And also, the T is really long. The rest of the design is really thin, so I cannot really imagine pairing that with some of the other pieces and not have it slide above or under some pieces, creating more wear than usual. If I could give you a specific example, you have one of those beaded bracelets, it will tuck under the huge logo or anything that comes in the way. So it does not make an ideal pairing for multiple bracelets wearing on your wrist. So to me, I think it might create a lot more work than I wanted to and more wear than I wanted to. The next piece I actually purchased and reviewed myself. However, I decided it's not really for me. Despite the beautiful design and the beautiful details, it does not pair with what I wear on the daily, and also the fact that it's designed in a dangly charm, it will be caught with other pieces that I'm wearing. And also our wrist size and a body build is very different, so particularly it didn't work out for me. That is Divas Dream that I reviewed in the video. If you are interested in this piece, do not hesitate to look into the review that I've done, because if you're thinking to wear just one or two simple pieces on your wrist, perhaps it works better for you. That is the second piece, which is from Bulgari's Divas Dream collection. So the next one, we have to visit some of sensitive and very overly protected brands, which are from Cartier, because I have reviewed and tried out quite many pieces to know exactly what works and what doesn't work for me. So I wanted to bring that perspective, and perhaps if you have a similar build or similar lifestyle, what I'm offering you today could be a better perspective for you. The piece that I picked out particularly is the small on Clou. Reason why is I think there is a better piece that is positioned in the collection. I do think the small just on Clou with diamonds have a better price point and position in the whole collection of the just on Clou line. After I've been trying it on with a stack, I just don't think my current stack goes very well with another piece that is smaller. Even though the piece has a lot of advantages, as it does not have a mechanism, instead it does have a bendable wire. So if you wear it, it's very unlikely to slide off your wrist or open. However, over periods of wearing, you might experience like the stretch of the bendable wire and etc. So if you want to look into more of an in-depth review, I do also have a video in the Cartier playlist, and I might link it in the comment section below, so make sure you check that out. After talking about Cartier, I do have to mention another piece I have reviewed on hand has become one of the items on this list. It is very popular popular, and it is Van Cleef & Arpels Sweet Alhambra collection, as I have borrowed my friend's beautiful set of the red carnelian stone in the Sweet Alhambra line in the heart shape. Both of them look super cute together as a set. If you wear a bracelet and a necklace, they look really cute together. My heart really belongs to the Sweet Alhambra clover charm in the red. I have worn that piece before and paired it with my Cartier stack, and I find it very statement-like, and people tend to recognize that shape and associate it with the brand. So if you're someone who are just starting your collection or who is trying to explore within the brand, the Sweet Alhambra collection is an excellent place to start, even though they're catching up with price increases. So if you're interested, look into that line. But this red little heart to me is a little bit too simple, and I just have more preferred choices from the lineup. Another piece I would not be purchasing from the Cartier's line is the tiny Trinity ring that is tied on a fabric. Even though by me saying this, I might have offended quite some friends from the luxe community, but like I said, everything we buy is a personal choice. For me, I did choose something maybe similar to the design of this one, which is the small love bracelet on the gold chain. I have done a 6-year review on it. If you guys want to check it out, you can check the links below or check out the Cartier playlist. The Trinity is another very iconic collection that Cartier had rolled out many years ago. It represents love. It has three different types of gold intertwined together. It has a beautiful design and it wears beautifully on our hands. However, for some reason, the bracelet just doesn't really speak to me, because I think if you're wearing fine jewelry with a piece of fabric, it does make the appearance of the bracelet look more casual versus a piece of jewelry. So depending on the look, I just personally do not like the look. However, that bracelet does give you the versatility to change color, as Cartier offers the threads in different colors, and I do think you can change them out and not pay a super heavy premium on it every time you wear it. And if it brings you some meaningful memories, obviously that's excellent, but it's not for me. All right, next let's go to one of my other favorite brands, Hermès. Hermès makes so many products actually in the jewelry department, from fashion jewelry to fine jewelry. As you guys saw, I have been shopping and more involved with their products because I just wanted to explore and see what suits me the most. So there will be more Hermès videos coming up. I have not shared with you guys that when I went into one of my appointments, I did request to try one of the newest dainty jewelry. It is called the New Farandole. As you guys know, Farandole is also very popular in their silver line, and I love the design. So when I explored a little bit more, I found out the Farandole has a new fine jewelry kind of edition, which is called the New Farandole. I was eyeing on this set, which is the New Farandole bracelet and also the New Farandole necklace. I obviously requested to try it on, and my local store didn't have it, so I actually had to wait until the piece came in. And unfortunately, it was quite disappointing to find out that the piece is not what I thought it would be. I was hoping that it would look nicer and bigger and more statement-like, even though it's a small model. The piece felt really insignificant and really, really light, as the chains are made up with all of these little Farandole links, and it was very, very small and felt very, very light on hand. Most importantly, when I paired it with my daily stack, it just looked like it's being eaten by all of the other pieces that's on my wrist. It did not give me the look I was looking for. Given that price point, I feel like you can go to Cartier or Van Cleef and collect a piece from either Love or the Sweet Alhambra collection. So under that comparison, I feel like the New Farandole small rose gold bracelet kind of failed on me. And if you're someone who loves Korean pop culture or K-drama or any kind of drama, you will know the Finesse collection under Hermès fine jewelry line is doing extremely well. I don't think my body frame or I have the build to make the bracelet look really, really dainty. The design is also very simple. Just took inspiration from their bracelets closure. They make pieces, they have the pavé design on it. So it could be a really nice little sparkling piece that adds to your layer, or you can wear it by yourself. Lastly, one more from Hermès, which are these ultra wide fashion jewelry bracelet, and they are white cuff enamel bracelet. Don't get me wrong, I do think there's beautiful design on it, as often the collection features the current scarf print or some special edition print as design on the bracelet. But the fact that the bracelet is just a round cuff, it does not have any closure, and when you wear it, it makes my style look very stuffy. Unless you have a very small and very skinny wrist, I don't think that particular design would suit most of us. And it's also very impractical to get in and out, as you have to make sure your hand bent certain ways in order to fit it in and out. There are two more pieces on this list. I think they're just popular by demand, and it has a very particular look. And I'm talking about the very famous tennis bracelet here. I believe this design has been made from fashion brands to fine jewelry brands. There are so many variations of it. It is just something sparkling. You don't know if someone's wearing diamond tennis bracelet or if they're just wearing a fashion piece. So it's hard to differentiate, and there's just too many looks to it. The reason why I do not like a tennis bracelet is because of the practicality. As you have to know, the diamonds have to be set into each of their own casting, and then it's made into a beaded bracelet. It is very beautiful, don't get me wrong. However, it is a pain to clean, and if you plan to wear that on the daily, the bracelet will probably lose its shine if you put like lotion, you wash your hands often, and it'll just pick up all the dust and dirts and, you know, daily life from it, and it stores in the bracelet. Many of us might have owned something similar to the design of a tennis bracelet. That could be a piece that you wear on special occasions, but definitely not something I personally would wear on the daily. However, it's not bad to own. I just don't think I'm ready to purchase or add that piece to my collection yet. The last piece I'm going to be surprising you guys, because you know that I have done real versus fake on the channel, and I often read comments like, there's absolutely no difference between the real and the fake bracelets, and the fake one looks just good enough to pass. I would never purchase a fake bracelet and wear them. Do not buy any fake designer bracelets. The quality of it just has nothing to do with a genuine piece. The level of detail and the level of design just has nothing to match. Why would you pick something that is not real but still wear it? That, I'm gonna leave it up to you, but that has made it to my top 10 list of designer bracelets that I would not purchase. Alrighty, you guys, these are my 10 choices. Do you have anything that you would like to add to this list? Let me know in the comment section below. And any questions, I look forward to answering them. I'll see you guys on the next one. Take care, bye.